high-risk anxiety. Those who have had cancer understand what I'm going through. All done. I did have to have contrast, which I wasn't aware. It took about 5 minutes. So now it's the worry, the good vibes, till I see my doctor next week. Wish me luck.
Hey, sorry I've been missing in action. I've just been waiting for results. So today's the day. So hopefully everything is good. And it was good news. There was no changes to my lymph node. So the problem was that I have a lymph node that lit up on my MRI, I believe, and then it lit up again on my CT mapping after the chemo. So that's what they were checking to see if the radiation had killed it or had, if anything had happened. So there's no change at all, which means basically there's a 99% chance that it's not cancer and it's just me. So we'll go back and have another scan in 3 months just to make sure that that is 100% the case. Good news, bud. Happy International Women's Day. Here's to strong women. May we know them, may we be them, may we raise them. I had the honour today of being on my health district's Facebook page for International Women's Day. Go me.
Wearing a bra?
No, I took that thing off. It was getting in the way of my girls.
Manic, I command you to put a bra on this instant.
I refuse!
It's my anniversary today. A year ago today, I started my treatment for breast cancer, and it started with a double mastectomy. I then had 5 months of chemo, I had 5 weeks of radiation, and then I had a full hysterectomy. So here we are a year later, and I have been reflecting on how my life is now. As for my mastectomy, I always feel tight across the chest area. They call it the iron bra. It's not too bad, but it does always feel like you actually have a bra on. Sometimes I get burning across my chest. Scarring actually looks pretty good. I put tattoos on today to celebrate, and plus I don't feel like I'm naked if I have fake tattoos on. But as you can see, the scarring is pretty good. I'm very lucky, very, very happy. I do have pain every day, joint pain, my ankles, my fingers hurt sometimes, definitely my knees hurt. That is because of a hormone blocker I have to have, so that causes that. So my life now, because of this one tablet, I have to take these ones for my joints, this one for pain, this one because the tablet makes me constipated, and this one because the chemo gave me vitamin D deficiency. I also have neuropathy in my toes, my feet and my fingers, so that's numbness in my fingertips, and I also have really bad nails, so I have a lot of trouble with picking up minor small things. My feet, they hurt. I have pain in my feet, I have burning in my toes. Sometimes I have pins and needles as well. So that's that symptoms. And then we've got sleep. Sometimes I can sleep, sometimes I cannot sleep. And for me, I'm very lucky. My mental health is very, very good. But I know for a lot of people, their mental health is still suffering after cancer. So I've been very, very lucky and have a very positive attitude. I try not to think about remission too much, if at all. I don't actually think about it at all until I have to have a scan. But yes, no, life is very, very good now, a year after starting cancer treatment. I'm very happy. Oh, and look at my hair. Look at that. That's where we are right there. Okay. Die, die.